Hello everyone. Today we are going to see about symmetrical component transformation. Phase sequence. A set of three balanced phasors VA, VB, VC or the current phasors IA, IB, IC are characterized by equal magnitudes and the interphasor difference of 120 degrees. Let us see with respect to the phasor diagram. Let us consider the VA as the reference phasor. So we have taken the VB, which is lagged behind the VA by 120 degrees phase angle. And the phasor VC is 120 degrees lag behind by VB, or you can say 240 degrees lag behind by the reference phasor VA. So this kind of phase sequence representation generally called as positive sequence. Operator A. This can also be represented by alpha or lambda. Different textbooks will follow the different notations for operator A. Application. It is used to represent the three phasors with respect to a reference phasor. So if you consider an unbalanced system, so we have a three phases. We are considering the unbalanced voltages as VA, VB, VC and currents as IA, IB, IC. Suppose if you want to represent all these three phasors with respect to a reference phase, it can be anything. It need not to be only the reference phasor VA. So it can be VB also, it can be VC also. So what is the value of this operator A? Operator A will have unity magnitude and rotation through 120 degrees. So operator A can be represented as 1 at an angle 120 degrees. So we should remember this 120 degrees, it will rotate anti-clockwise direction. It will rotate the vector in anti-clockwise direction. It's very, very important. Now what this operator will do? How this operator will work? If you multiply this operator with any vector, it will retain that vector magnitude as it is, but it will change its direction by 120 degrees in anti-clockwise direction. For example, let us consider phase A. So you can consider either voltage or we can consider current also. Let us consider this VA is having a magnitude of 10 volts. I am assuming this voltage as a reference vector. So what is meant by the reference vector? Its phase angle will be 0 degrees. So the vector VA can be written as magnitude is 10 volts and the angle is 0 degrees. So now look at this. I am going to multiply this vector VA with respect to the operator A. So what is the value of operator A? I know operator A is equal to 1 at an angle 120 degrees and I know my vector VA is equal to 10 volts at an angle 0 degrees. Let me multiply A into VA. A into VA vector is equal to, so now both if you multiply 1 at an angle 120 degrees into 10 at an angle 0 degrees. So what will happen? It is a multiplication in polar form. So 1 into 10, 10 volts. If you, these two angles will get added together. So that will become 120 degrees. So what happened here? The magnitude of the voltage VA and the magnitude of AVA both are same. So VA magnitude, AVA magnitude both are same. So where the difference has come? The difference has come in the angle. So previously it was 0 degrees. Now it has become 120 degrees. So that means by multiplying this operator A, the direction of this phasor will change. So how it will change? This will rotate by 120 degrees. So now let us see that. So this is how the direction of the phasor will change. So what is that? Let us give a baseline to this. So previously it was in this direction. Okay, so let us take this is VA. Now because of this multiplication of A, my VA vector has moved from this position to this position. This is nothing but 120 degrees. This can be written as A into VA. Next, similarly, A square is equal to 1 at an angle 120 degrees. How? We know A square is equal to A into A. So A we know 1 at an angle 120 degrees into 1 at an angle 120 degrees. So the magnitude will be same, the angles we can add directly. 120 plus 120 is equal to 240 degrees. So the A square value will be to 1 at an angle 240 degrees. Therefore, operator A square will rotate any phasor in anti-clockwise direction by 240 degrees. Like last example, we will take the same phasor VA. So this is 10 volts. Now, if you multiply with A square is equal to 1 at an angle 240 degrees, and here the VA value is equal to 10 at an angle 0 degrees. So now the A square VA is equal to 10 at an angle 240 degrees. What does that mean? Now here you can see the resultant phasor also I have represented. So this is VA. Now how to represent? This vector will rotate only in anti-clockwise direction if you use the operator A. So now 240 degrees it will take the rotation if you multiply any vector with A square. So this is nothing but A square into VA. So what is the magnitude of this? The magnitude will be same as VA. So now coming to the actual concept, the main aim of the operator A is to represent all the three phases with respect to a reference phasor. So all the three phases means out of three phases, one phase anyway we will consider as a reference. So other two phases also will be represented in terms of the reference phase. Now here I am considering the voltage VA as a reference phasor. So the voltage VA as a reference phasor. So now I want to represent the VB value, VC value in terms of VA value. So let us consider VA as a reference phasor, VB in terms of VA. So what I have to get? This VB value, I want to represent VA value. What does that mean? This vector has to move like this and should reach to this position. So it has to move and come to this position so that this value will be equal to VB. So how it will move? It has to move in anti-clockwise direction. And what is the angle here? This is 240 degrees. Which will rotate this vector 240 degrees in anti-clockwise direction? That we know it is none other than operator A square. So very simple. Now if you multiply A square with VA, we will get the VB value. Similarly, if I want to get VC value in terms of VA, this VA phasor has to come to this VC position. So what is the angle between these two? 120 degrees. Means the VA has to move 120 degrees in anti-clockwise direction So then that will be equal to BC. So the BC in terms of VA can be represented as A into VA. So these three values, now the VA value, what is a VA value? VA value is a reference. So you can represent VA is nothing but VA. So now you can say you got the VA value in terms of VA, VB value in terms of VA, VC value also in terms of VA. That means all the equations which are having A, B, C terms has converted into only one phase. Only one phase, that is reference phase. So it can be anything, it can be B, it can be C, it can be A also. With regard to this, operator A plays a very important role in the analysis of unsymmetrical fault. Important relations of operator A. To study the further relations and to do the numericals related to this unsymmetrical fault, we need some important relations of operator A. We know operator A is equal to 1 at an angle 120 degrees. This can also be written as e power j 120 degrees. So this e power j theta can be written as cos theta plus j sin theta. So that is cos 120 degrees plus j sin 120. So the cos 120 will be equal to minus 0.5. J sin 120 will give you 0.866. This is point 1. Second point, A square is equal to 1 at an angle 240 degrees. If you represent in a similar way, e power j 240 is equal to cos 240 plus j sin 240 degrees. This will give us minus 0.5 minus j 0.866. So the third important relation is a cube is equal to, so how much is a cube? 1 at an angle. So 3 times you will add that 120 degrees. So that will become 360 degrees, which is also represented as at an angle 0 degrees. So now finally what you can say, a cube is equal to 1. This can also be represented as a cube minus 1 equal to 0. If we simplify this, a minus 1 into a square plus a plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, a minus 1 cannot be equal to 0. Why? Means a is not equal to 1. How we have come to this conclusion? If you see here, the operator A is a complex number. Operator A is a complex number because we are representing A as a 1 at an angle 120 degrees, which is a complex number. So it cannot be equal to the real number. So definitely A will not be equal to 1. Therefore, A square plus a plus 1 should be equal to 0. So this is one of the important relation that we need. So fourth relation is a square plus a plus 1 equal to 0. Fifth relation, if you find a power 4, that will be equal to a. A power 4 is nothing but a cube into a. So what is the value of a cube? A cube is nothing but 1. So 1 into a will give you a. Next, a minus a square. A value is minus 0.5 plus j 0.866 minus a square value is minus 0.5 minus j 0.866. If you simplify this, minus 0.5 plus j 0.866 minus plus 0.5 and minus again you will get plus j 0.866. So these two will get cancelled. You will get j 0.866 plus j 0.866 will give you j 1.732, which is equal to j root 3. So therefore, you can say a minus a square is equal to j root 3. Similarly, if you simplify an equation for a square minus a, this will result into minus j root 3. Equation number 8. What is the a square conjugate and a conjugate? So a square conjugate, a square is minus 0.5 minus j 0.866, whole conjugate will give you. What is the job of conjugate? It will change the imaginary part sign. So minus 0.5 plus j 0.866, which is nothing but a. A conjugate will give you. So a conjugate a is minus 0.5 plus j 0.86. Conjugate will change this sign. Again, it will result into a square. So what is that? A square conjugate is a and a conjugate is a square. These many equations we need to understand the further concepts in a better way. So you people no need to mug up all these values. You just remember the one equation, that is a is equal to 1 at an angle 120 degrees. And from that equation, you can derive all these equations. So let us summarize all these equations. So you can understand how we got this a square plus a plus 1 relation from this note. So these are very, very important relations. Thank you.